Good morning everyone. Today we discuss about respiratory system of frog. Due to amphibious mode of life, frogs shows different modes of respiration. Branchial respiration, cutaneous respiration, buccopharyngeal respiration, pulmonary respiration. Branchial respiration, respiration by gills called branchial respiration. Branchial respiration occurs in larval stage of frogs. Larval stages of frogs. The larva stage of frog is tadpole larva. Tadpole larva is aquatic organism. In tadpoles, respiration by gills called branchial respiration. Gills are highly vascular. Highly vascular means highly blood supply. The gas is exchanged between the dissolved water and blood vessels. Next, cutaneous respiration, buccopharyngeal respiration and pulmonary respiration. These are occurs in the adult frog. Adult frogs. Next, cutaneous respiration. Respiration by skin is called cutaneous respiration. In frogs, skin is thin, moist, scaleless, and vascular. Vascular means blood supply. Skin permeable to gases. Moist skin. The skin is moist by the mucus glands present on the skin releases mucus, so skin is moist. Scaleless skin allows the gases. Highly vascular nature. These conditions are required for the exchange of gases through the skin. When the skin is dried, the frog dies due to the lack of oxygen. Because of cutaneous respiration is not possible. When frog lives in water, the gases exchange through the skin. During the hibernation and estivation, gases takes place through the skin. Land, water and hibernation and estivation. These periods the gases exchange through the skin. Dissolved oxygen in the water exchanged through skin by diffusion. So skin acts as aquatic respiratory organ in frogs. In frogs, atmospheric gases dissolved in the mucous membrane. Atmospheric gases dissolved in the mucous membrane and then diffused into the capillaries of skin. So, skin allows the gases. Next, buccopharyngeal respiration. Buccopharyngeal respiration. Buccal cavity. Buccopharyngeal respiration by buccal cavity. Buccopharyngeal respiration by buccal cavity. Buccal cavity is thin, highly vascular. Highly vascular. Gases exchange through the buccal cavity. Through the buccal cavity is called buccopharyngeal respiration. Next, pulmonary respiration. Pulmonary respiration. Pulmonary respiration takes by lungs. Lungs. Lungs are elongated, spongy, highly vascular, sac-like structures. These lungs are present on the These lungs are present on the upper part of the trunk region. Lungs are present on the upper part of the trunk region. In pulmonary respiration, two muscles are involved. The pterohilus muscle and sternohilus muscle. During inspiration, Sternohilus muscle contraction. Due to the contraction of sternohilus muscle, the floor of buccopharyngeal cavity lowered. So, the volume increases in the buccopharyngeal cavity. Pressure decreases in the buccopharyngeal cavity. Atmospheric air enters into the buccopharyngeal cavity through external nostrils. When the opening of lung is called glottis. At this time, glottis is closed. When pterohilus muscle contraction, the floor of the buccopharyngeal cavity is elevated. So the pressure increases in the buccopharyngeal cavity. Nostrils are also closed. When high pressure of the buccopharyngeal cavity, the glottis opens and air enters into the lungs through the buccopharyngeal cavity. After exchange of gases, Sternohilus muscle contraction causes lowering of the buccopharyngeal cavity. Area of the buccopharyngeal cavity increases. So, the pressure decreases in the buccopharyngeal cavity. Air comes into the buccal cavity from the lungs. When pterohilus muscle contraction causes the elevate the buccopharyngeal cavity. Elevate the buccopharyngeal cavity causes area of the buccopharyngeal cavity decreases. So pressure increases in the buccopharyngeal cavity. Air goes out through nostrils. At that time, the glottis remain closed. Buccopharyngeal respiration occurs when frog lives on the land. Pulmonary respiration occurs when frog lives on the land. But cutaneous respiration occurs when frog lives on land and water. So, cutaneous respiration is more important of the three types. Cutaneous respiration is more important of the three types.